we've only really had the technology to be able to create digital conversational agents within the past century. And the most dramatic advances in the field of artificial intelligence have really only happened within the past two decades. It's still a very new field. Similarly, the job title of conversation designer wasn't really popularized until 2017. We've all been trying for some time to develop and improve conversational experiences, mostly at different rates, with some companies more ahead than others. It's part of the reason why not all conversational agents or chatbots actually leverage AI. In fact, while it's true that the first chatbot in the world, called Eliza, was developed between the years 1964 and 1966, Eliza itself was technically not an artificial intelligence. Imagine someone writing code for how a parrot imitates human words. That was basically it. The code for Eliza gave it the ability to detect keywords and reply to messages according to the keyword it detected. So this is a sample exchange from the original paper in 1996. You can see that there is regurgitation of the user sentences, but not much manipulation of the content beyond that. After detecting this keyword depressed, Eliza would simply state, "I am sorry to hear you're depressed." Its behavior would always fall within the realm of if-else statements. For this reason, Eliza is considered a rule-based chatbot. There was no automated learning, which meant its responses would not change over time. And yet, there were those who tested Eliza and were expertly deceived into thinking that it was real and could understand them. The principal developer of Eliza was very cautious about what he had created. In his original paper, Weizenbaum wrote, "The crucial test of understanding is not the subject's ability to continue a conversation, but to draw valid conclusions from what he is being told." Eliza proved to him that it was very easy to create and maintain the illusion of understanding, but that we should take these experiences with a grain of salt and caution those who chat with these agents. So what learnings can we take from Eliza? Even with very basic technology behind it, Eliza was able to amuse and engage the people who chatted with it. It did this in two key ways: by staying on topic and acknowledging what was said. One, Eliza teaches us that relevance is king when it comes to designing conversations. You don't want the conversational agent to be the one changing the subject unless it's somehow related to previous context. Two, reassurances go a very, very long way. To talk to Eliza, a person had to type into a computer screen. The screen itself had no appearance and would not show any other features while conversing. There's no eye contact and no body language. The only way a user could be sure that their input was received was for the chatbot to mirror the input or use the input as content for its response. The third lesson is not necessarily something Eliza did, but rather what it revealed about us as people. When computers show even the smallest hint of humanness, people begin to treat that entity like a social being itself. When executed right, this would mean that people might be more receptive to a conversational agent than other digital products.